Hello and welcome back to your own channel Indian Defense Analysis, where we bring to you all the latest development happening in the defense sector.
With Pakistan acquiring 25 J-10C to counter Rafales, the discussions related to its capabilities has heated up. We have already made a detailed video on comparison between J-10C and Rafales. In today's discussion, we'll be comparing J-10C with India's upcoming indigenous fighter jet Tejas Mk2. The Chinese J-10C is a bigger aircraft when compared to Tejas Mk2, which means it will have more RCS when compared to Tejas Mk2. The RCS of J-10C is approximated to be about 1 meter square, whereas that of Tejas Mk2 is between 0 to 0.2 meter square. The huge difference between RCS of both the fighters is not just because of size, but it's because of heavy use of radar absorbent material in Tejas Mk2. More than 90% of components of Tejas Mk2, such as wings, fuselage, rudder, canards, will be made up of composite, which makes the plane durable, light and stealthier. The cockpit of the aircraft will have a golden colored tint, and same you would have noticed in Rafale and F-22 Raptor. It's because of the layer of indium tin oxide, which helps the plane to vanish the detection, which is possible and is created by HMD, Helmet Mounted Display of Pilot. The Y-shaped air intake of this Mk2 further enhances its stealth characteristic. Having considerably low RCS, J-10C will have difficult time in detecting Tejas Mk2, while the latter can easily lock and engage from much farther distance. Tejas Mk2 will have upper range of first strike against J-10C. A fighter jet is no good without its weapon. The J-10C will have only Chinese-made weapons, whereas Tejas Mk2 will have Indian as well as Western weapons integrated with it. Both the fighters will have 11 hardpoints. Tejas Mk2 weighs around 7,850 kgs and has a maximum takeoff weight of 17,500 kgs, whereas J-10C weighs around 9,750 kgs and has a maximum takeoff weight of 19,277 kgs. If you consider the difference between empty weight and maximum takeoff weight of the fighters, they are almost the same, which means Tejas Mk2, even being smaller than J-10C fighter, has similar payload capacity. Talking about weapons, Tejas Mk2 will have far more versatile and better weapons than Chinese J-10C. In BVR segment, the fighter will have Astra series of missiles, Mika NG Meteor, and ASR-AM and Python 5 in within visual range category. If we look at J-10C inventory, it is equipped with PL-15 as BVR missile and PL-8 and PL-10 missiles for within visual range. The Chinese missiles are no match to the Astra, MBDAs and Israeli missiles. While PL-15 claims to have range between 200 to 300 kilometers, if that's true, it will be only effective against refuelers and AWACS. At such a long range, the missile will not have enough energy to chase a highly maneuverable fighter jet, especially Indian fighters like Su-30 MKIs, Rafales and Tejas. The Pakistani J-10C will feature the export variant of PL-15 missile, which has range limited to 145 kilometers, lesser than MBDS Meteor and Astra Mk2. Nothing beats BrahMos when it comes to ground attack capabilities. Besides BrahMos NG, Tejas Mk2 will also be armed with Rudram, Scalp, LR-LACM, Hammer, Spice 1000 and Saw. Again, what we see here is the best weapon package of indigenous and Western world. J-10C also features the land attack standoff and cruise missile, but they are no match for capabilities offered by weapon package of Tejas Mk2. The J-10C features an indigenously developed AESA radar with 1200 TR modules. While the TR module seems to be high, powered by a single AL-31 engine may not be sufficient to generate enough power for 1200 TRs. At the same time, Tejas Mk2 will feature upgraded Uttam AESA radar with 912 to 968 TR modules, which is based on gallium nitride. These radars packs more power in less space. The power generated by gallium nitride radar is double of that of Uttam AESA Mk1, which is gallium arsenide based. Even with lesser number of TR modules, this Mk2 will feature more powerful radar due to gallium arsenide technology. Tejas Mk2 will feature all the latest electronics, avionics and electronic warfare system being developed for MCA program. Tejas Mk2 will also incorporate advanced electronic warfare suite, superior data link and software. It will have IRST sensors and missile approach warning system integrated. The aircraft will be designed to have network-centric warfare capability, which means it can get or share target locations to engage from other fighter jets or ground-based radars. The aircraft will also be powered by artificial intelligence, and when pilot goes unconscious, its control will be automatically transferred to ground control. Not much is known about the electronic warfare capabilities of JTNC. However, it reportedly has IRST, electronic warfare suite, missile approach warning system, and radar warning receiver. However, the technology developed is more than a decade old, as the first J-10C to enter in service was in 2005. Tejas Mk2 will have advantage of being developed late to feature all the latest technology than compared to J-10C. The J-10C cockpit displays include a helmet-mounted weapon sight, a wide field of view heads-up display, and one full-color and two monochrome liquid crystal multifunction displays. Tejas Mk2 is to be equipped with a high-definition touchscreen measuring 50 by 20 centimeters wide area display that will allow a redundant and intelligent presentation of information across its entire length, with the capacity to receive inputs from multitask keys, the touchscreen, or external interfaces. The wide area display in Tejas Mk2 is considered as the great step forward in the cockpit display technology, with significant operation capability advantage to meet the demands of existing and future threats, and also handle high volumes of data, supporting the pilot's ability to select, launch and guide weapons in perfect coordination. The J-10C features conventional style center stick controller, while Tejas Mk2 will feature side stick controller like the Dassault Rafale and F-35 Lightning II, which will help to reduce the cockpit clutter. The J-10C is powered by much powerful engine than Tejas Mk2, but the advantage of powerful engine is taken away due to the heavy empty weight of the fighter jet. The J-10C is mostly powered by Russian AL-31FN engine. However, we have also seen the integration of Chinese WS-10 engines with it. But it is not clear if Pakistan will get which one. We might have to wait till the jets are delivered. The engine generates thrust of 125 kN. Tejas Mk2 features G414 engine, which produces a dry thrust of 58 kN and 98 kN of thrust with afterburner. The G engines have reputation of high availability as compared to Russian or Chinese engines. When we talk about aerodynamic performance, both the fighters are almost equal in capabilities. Both the fighters exhibit G limit of -3G to +9G with max speed of Mach 1.8. Overall, Tejas Mk2 will have advantage of better electronics and avionics than J-10C as its segue for all the fifth-gen technology. The use of extensive composite material and RAM has added the stealth characteristic as well. The versatile weapon package further makes the fighter much lethal. J-10C, being developed much early, will have to do a lot of catch-up with the upcoming India's 4.5th generation fighter.
This was today's update. Please let us know what is your views about these in comment section. Feel free to post your comments and suggestions about any topic related to defense sector on which you want to hear from us. With this, I would like to say goodbye and Jai Hind, friends. Please like and subscribe our video if you have not done already. We'll be soon back with more interesting and amazing development happening in defense sector.